Praise the Lord. Good evening, everyone. It's a joy and privilege to meet you all through this Wednesday evening worship service. It's as usual, we meet online and we as a family together, we are going to sing few songs, choruses, and then we will have the Bible portion reading. That's kind of, it's more of a Bible study, and then we will have the intercession for the needs of the people. Now, we will sing few choruses. Before that, shall we look to the Lord in prayer? Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for the grace and mercy you have granted unto us. This is the first Wednesday of May 2020. As we are in the lockdown confinement, Father, we pray that your inspiring spirit be with us, Lord, and as we meditate thy word, as we worship thee, it's a family together. It's more a family call. Father, we come before thy throne. Inspire us, Lord, and use us mightily to touch the lives of the viewers who are viewing this program, the recording program through YouTube, O Father. Be with us, Lord, and let this media bring glory and honor unto thy name. As we minister unto thee through this media, let the hearts and minds of thy people, the people of redemption, touched by the power of the Holy Spirit, O Master. We surrender ourselves unto thy loving care. Take full control over us and let the people join us, Lord, for your glory and for the edification of the church. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. My dear friends, it's a joy for us to sing together. Sing to God, sing unto the Lord a new song. When we sing to God, it's a kind of worship. We worship the Lord. When we worship the Lord, the triune God will intervene us and we will be transformed. The whole being would be transformed. As we sing, at the time of singing, we will feel the presence of the Lord and miracle will happen. This is the understanding with the word of the Lord. We will sing a song, new songs. And it is old songs only, 33 in the song book, In His Time. And this is the familiar song, everyone can sing, everyone can follow. Song number 33 on page 20. We will sing.
I have to
his time, in God's time. In the fullness of time came, God sent his only begotten son. That time. We should be aware of God's time. Because everything, God's will is being done according to the time that has been ascertained. So we have to visualize the time. In his own time, everything will happen. And everything, God will make everything beautiful in his time. That's a very meaningful song. Another song you are going to sing. I will sing mercies of the Lord. God's mercy is forever. And his faithfulness is new every morning. And we acknowledge the mercies of the Lord. How we live, it is because of God's grace. We are attracted by the God's grace. And we have to sing praises unto God for what he has granted us. And that is because of God's mercy. With that meaning, shall we sing this chorus 25. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord.
I will sing of the mercies of the Lord forever. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord. Not will I make known thy faithfulness with my mouth.
His mercies endures forever, and we have the God's mercy, and because of God's mercy we live and what we are now. We have to acknowledge the grace God has granted unto our life in each and every moment of our lives as a matter of gratitude. Now we have the hope on Christ's name. In the name of Jesus we have the victory in everything. Everything will be done in the name of Jesus. Jesus says, Ask, if he shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. He stresses his name, in my name, I will do it. So when we call unto his name under the sun, only one name is given for the humanity. The human being are expected to call that name. If we call into that name, miracle will happen. Whatever the situation may be you are going through, you will succeed, and you will come out of the situation, and you will be able to defeat the work of the devil. With that understanding, we will sing the Lord in the name of Jesus. We will have the victory. Song number 26.
We have the victory. of Jesus, Satan will have to flee. Who can tell what God can do? Who can tell His love for you? In the name of Jesus, Jesus, we have the victory.
In God's name, everything will happen. So Jesus says, the word of God reminds us, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous who are redeemed by the precious blood of Jesus of Nazareth, they will run unto it and be safe. So under the sun, the name Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue confess, every knee, in a sense, in the knees of coronavirus, like the pandemic diseases and every natural calamity, what all the things which is sent before you as a threat, when you climb that name, it will bow down before the name. So you will be, ultimately you will be victorious. We thank God for the name God has granted unto the humanity to pronounce. Now we will have a Hindi chorus. Now shall we sing a new Hindi chorus? Dhanyavad, Dhanyavad Deta Hoon. Like with that meaning, we will give thanks to God. With that meaning, we will sing the Hindi song. Yeah.
Oh, my God.
delicious time of prayer, sweet time of prayer. And we request you all, wherever you are at home, you please come to the presence of the Lord with singing. If you can sing songs and if you can worship the Lord, and you will feel the difference, you will see the difference in your life. That's the understanding behind this. And God has granted His victory unto us to sing praises unto God, because the life we have received from God is precious, and we should be accountable. We must all be accountable to God for the life God has granted unto us. We praise God for this time of worship together in this manner, in this evening. This is the first Wednesday of the month of May 2020. We will have, God willing, we will continue this worship on every Wednesday evening 7:30. And this will be released. It will come to you exactly 7:30 in the evening. May God be with you, and we will have the scripture portion. Now, as usual, we are continuing the Bible study. And now we have taken the portion, 1 Timothy. It is called the pastoral epistle of Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul wrote the epistle to the Timothy. First epistle to Timothy, and second epistle to Timothy, and then another epistle to Titus. They are the workers, workmanship. They are the companionship. They are the God's providence along with working along with Apostle Paul. And we are going to meditate on the first chapter of 1 Timothy chapter 1. And we will read five verses each, and then we will have the discussion, a group discussion or something like that, the Bible study. You all will enjoy this Bible study. Shall we read the scripture? Who will read? Yeah. 1 Timothy chapter 1. Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus, according to the commandment of God, our Savior, and of Christ Jesus, who is our hope. To Timothy, my true son, my true child in the faith, grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father and Christ Jesus our Lord. As I urge you upon my departure for Macedonia, remain on at Ephesus, in order that you may instruct certain men not to teach strange doctrines, nor to pay attention to myths and endless genealogies, which give rise to mere speculation rather than furthering the administration of God, which is by faith. But the goal of our instruction is love from a pure heart and a good conscience and a sincere faith.
Some have departed from this and have turned to meaningless talk. They want to be teachers of the law, but they do not know what they are talking about or what they so confidently affirm. We know that the law is good if one uses it properly. We also know that the law is made not for the righteous, but for lawbreakers and rebels, the ungodly and sinful, the unholy and irreligious, for those who kill their fathers or mothers, for murderers, for the sexually immoral, for those practicing homosexuality, for slave traders and liars and perjurers, and for whatever else is contrary to the sound doctrine
that conforms to the gospel concerning the glory of the blessed God, which he entrusted to me. I thank Christ Jesus our Lord, who has given me strength, that he considered me trustworthy, appointing me to his service. Even though I was once a blasphemer and a persecutor and a violent man, I was shown mercy because I acted in ignorance and unbelief. The grace of our Lord was poured out on me abundantly, along with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. Here's a trustworthy saying that deserves full acceptance. Jesus Christ came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the worst.
But for that very reason, I was shown mercy, so that in me, the worst of sinners, Christ Jesus might display his immense patience as an example of those who would believe in him and receive eternal life. Now, to the King eternal, immortal, invisible, and only God be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. Timothy, my son, I am giving you this command in keeping with the prophecies once made about you, so that by recalling them you may fight the battle well. Holding on to the faith and a good conscience, which some have rejected and so have suffered shipwreck with regard to the faith. Among them are Hymenaeus and Alexander, whom I have handed over to Satan to be taught not to blaspheme.
Yeah, may God inspire us with his divine verse, and we will live by his word only. May God bless us, bless our reading. The Apostle Paul writes letter to Timothy. This is the first letter to Timothy. It's written about 62 AD. After death, 62 years, this letter has been written. It's recorded in the historicity of the Bible. Now it is our joy and privilege to analyze the word of the Lord. Normally this epistle is called pastoral epistle. A pastor or a man of God or a woman of God or the servant of God or the believer, how the person should need to be, qualified in these chapters, in this Bible verses. Now if we can meditate, God will definitely inspire us to handle his word, and it will be reflected in and through our words and deeds. Now the first verse, Paul an apostle means a sent one, an ambassador for Christ. I am somebody, so and so is sent by somebody. So Paul, a person of Christ Jesus, sent by God. And we are all chosen people. God says in Psalm 4:3, God has set apart the godly for himself. This man, Paul, before his conversion, he was Saul. And he was a very good man, lawkeeper. He was almost blameless in keeping the law. And having kept the law in his mind and heart, and he is also a man, sat at the feet of Gamaliel, the Greek philosopher. And he was highly learned man. And he was highly esteemed man. And he has everything on the earth. And this is the additional qualification. But with all these things, he wanted to torment the people of God. He wanted to persecute the people of God, Christians. He did not like the Christian. And eventually, what did he do? He wanted to persecute the Christians in the first century Christians. Set out his journey to persecute Christians. On the way to Damascus, we are troubled, definitely the caretaker God will come in the picture. Now we don't belong to our own. We are sent by God in this earth to fulfill certain responsibilities. Once it is done, we will be called for the higher service. That is the understanding of the humankind. So this man, as he was walking along the road to Damascus to persecute the Christians, God came unto his scene as a rescue for his people, because the Christians are depending upon Jesus, the Savior, and Jesus is their rescue, their Savior. And the people, there was a vast hue and cry by the Christians. And in the Damascus road, Jesus stood. And while this man, Saul, he was coming along the road, to persecute the Christians, immediately God, Jesus stopped him with an alleviation, in a sense with a trance, the vision. In the vision, he could hear the voice of Jesus. God's, what did God say? This is the background of Paul. If we know the background of Paul, then only we will be able to understand what he has written to the people and the epistles and the churches. Corinth, Galatia, Galatia and several Ephesus, several other areas. And this man, he was on the road, Damascus, on the Damascus road, to persecute the Christians. Immediately the voice came out, "Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me?" And this is the way. That's the background. And God further says, "It is hard for you to kick at the goats." Hard for you to kick at the goats. The people who despise the chosen one will be under condemnation. And God was giving warning to the person Saul. "Who are you?" He immediately asked God, "Who are you, Lord?" And he said, "I am the one whom you are persecuting. I am the one. You are persecuting my children, Christians." And Jesus says, "I am persecuted by you." So this is the rescue. This is the savior attitude. And he was caught up. Paul was caught up. This is the background of Paul. And now, let's come to the another section of this verse. "According to the commandment of God, our Savior, and of Christ Jesus, who is our hope." Okay, the hope. I just highlight some of the term words which is seen in the chapter. The hope. What is the hope? Generally, the verse 1 and 2, it gives a salutation of this chapter. Salutation, greetings. And then 3 to 11, Timothy charged to oppose the false teachers. That's an instruction given to Timothy against the concerning the false teachers. And verse 12 to 17, Lord's grace to Paul. And 18 to 20, the charge to Timothy renewed. This is the outline of the whole chapter. Now, the apostle Paul was called by God to proclaim the hope. Hope, what do you mean by hope? The first verse, it is written hope. There's a eschatological events yet to happen in the near future or the days to come. That's the hope. Our hope, Christian hope, is second coming of our Lord and Jesus Christ, subsequently the tribulation, the taken up period, and during which the tribulation will go on in the earth. And then 1,000 years reign, something like that. You will be aware of all such things in the scripture. It is written in the scripture. And verse 2, Timothy, my true child in the faith. Apostle Paul addressed Timothy. Timothy, my true child in the faith. He is my true child. Timothy is called by Apostle Paul my true child. And so he was so close to the Timothy in faith. And then the Timothy charged to oppose the main contention of the verses between 3 and 11. Timothy charged to oppose false teachers. Here verse 4. What is that? The main purpose of writing this is written in chapter 1 verse 3. Macedonia, I urge you, Timothy, remain at Ephesus in order that you may instruct certain men not to teach strange doctrines. So he is the caretaker, he is the preserver of the church. He has been given church ministry over there in Ephesus. That's the understanding. And he was the caretaker to take care of the church. Strange doctrine. Nowadays we can see some of the strange doctrines as in South India or some other places. People are expected to not to wear gold ornaments. the Christians, quote unquote Christians, and they should forsake the gold ornaments and give away the gold ornaments. And the second strange doctrine is the locking spirit. When we worship the Lord, the people who are worshiping, they have their own tendency to laugh. Ah, this is the locking spirit. That's a strange doctrine. Another doctrine is vomiting spirit. When we worship the Lord, if you take vomit, and we thinking that our past sin is forgiven, it's gone. That's a strange doctrine. That's how Apostle Paul entrusted the responsibility. Last days the heretical teaching will come. You preserve the people of God at Ephesus. That's how he was charged. The Apostle Paul has given a charge to Timothy to take care of the needs. And this is 3 to 11. He has to oppose the false teachings, genealogies, and several few fruitless discussion, and verse 6, and then law keeping, things like that. So that it is not meaningful at all. It is not profitable at all. Useless talk. You keep yourselves away from the useless chatter. Like that, the instruction was given by Apostle Paul. There are the verse 6. Some men straying from these teachings have turned aside the fruitless discussion. The supporting verses is Titus 1:10. What it is written there? There are some rebellious people filled with the meaningless talk and deception. You have to be aware of such people and you have to counter such people. That's how the instruction was given by Apostle Paul to Timothy, his beloved child, true child. Verse 8 says, the law is good. The law keeper. There are some law keepers. Law is good. Law is holy, righteousness and good. Law is not made for the righteous people. The law is made for the people who are ungodly and sinners. The righteous people they don't need the law because their sins are already forgiven and they are keeping the law through Christ Jesus' blood. And they are purified and they are redeemed people, and for them the law doesn't require because they are walking in the light and their word of God is in their heart, and the law is required for the ungodly and sinners. That is verse 9 and 10 also. Immoral, sexuals, kidnappers, liars, perjurers, and the people who are having the teaching of the contrary of the sound teachings. And then verse 12, this is another thing. The Christ Jesus our Lord, who has strengthened me because he has considered me faithful. This is something different. God has considered his children faithful. And this Apostle Paul entrusted the responsibility to Timothy to be faithful, because the supporting verses is Acts 9:15. And John 15:16, God says, God has entrusted this responsibility, because John 15:16, we did not choose God, God has chosen us. In a sense, we don't belong to us, and we belong to God. And since God has chosen us, we have to do certain responsibilities and duties for the cause of the church, the people of God. And that's how he says, no? He was chosen. Apostle Paul was a chosen man to minister unto the Gentiles, kings, sons of Israel, and several so on and so forth. Verse 14, grace of our Lord was more on me. Here Paul says the grace of the Lord was, he was praising God for his grace. And verse 15, Christ Jesus came into this world to save sinners, among whom I am worst of all. So this is the humble statement made by Apostle Paul. He had a lot of titles, secular and several other titles in the Sanhedrin. He became a member and several other areas. He was a mighty leader in those places. And the qualification, he used to sit at the feet of Gamaliel, the Greek philosopher. That also, that man says, the highest man in all the qualities and qualifications, he humbles himself. Christ Jesus came into this world to save the sinner, among whom I am the worst sinner. I am foremost of all. The humility is maintained now. And another thing Paul highlights here, verse 18 to 20, the charge to Timothy renewed. See, this is 2 Timothy 1st chapter 1 6 says, this verse is supporting to 1st chapter verse 18. This command I entrust to you, Timothy, my son, in accordance with the prophecies previously made concerning you, that by them you may fight the good fight. The exhortation is, you, Timothy, you have to fight a good fight. Fight a good fight. 2 Timothy 4:4 says, Paul himself says, I have fought a good fight. Good fight, and I have finished the race, and I have kept the faith. Here, from this day on, the crown of righteousness is set before me. That's the way he fought, and he conquered, and he has succeeded. 2 Timothy 1:6 says, stir up the God's gift, fan into flame the gift of God that is in you. He was kindling his faith, fight the good fight. And verse 19, keeping faith and a good conscience, which some have rejected and suffered shipwreck. They have, some people shipwrecked their faith, broken their faith. That's the example is also given among those people, Imenas and Alexander, whom I have delivered over to Satan. See, this is the important thing to understand. Apostle Paul handed over some people to Satan. Why he has handed over such people to Satan? They were against the doctrine of Christ Jesus. They were again, they have broken the faith, and they have violated the grace, and eventually they were handed over to Satan. This is a heartbreaking verse written. Why they are given to Satan? Because their deeds are not appropriate, not fair in the presence of the Lord, and their faith was shipwrecked. It means the faith was broken. They have collapsed their faith, and they did not listen to the word of God anymore. They did not respect Apostle Paul anymore. That's how he has handed over such people unto the devil. So this chapter ends now. There are several things we have to go through. Due to the time constraint, we have to do justice for the prayer time. And now this is the time for the intercession. May God help us to understand the word that has been read during this time of fellowship together in this evening. Continuously may God speak to each and every one of us. Now this is the time for the intercession. Wherever you are asked to, or you are requested to pray together as a family, this is the time. This is a lockdown period. It is meant for us to come together as a family together to seek the Lord in one accord. When we seek the Lord as a family, definitely we will see the miracle. We will see the work of the Lord in our lives. And this Joshua says, as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord. So this is a rare golden opportunity God has given to each and every one of us to be at home, to have fellowship with one another. At the same time, as a family together, when we worship the Lord, the divine intervention will come upon us and we will be healed physically and spiritually. Now this is the time, the crucial time. As we are well aware of the coronavirus, and the virus is virus has killed 2,52,950 people all over the land, throughout the whole globe. 2,52,950 people. They were killed by this cruel and vile COVID-19. And we have to make intercession for the people of God, who are all in all the uttermost parts of this earth. They are all created in God's image only. So we need to pray for those people. God has instructed us, man or woman, I have installed you, I have appointed you as a watchman. You have to watch the people and you have to be aware of the problem, struggle, the effect of the virus going around. And you should instruct the people, you should rescue the people from the fowler snare and the deadly pestilence. That's how we are here, to intercede for the people who are affected with the coronavirus. I am going to mention some of the points. We just keep this in mind and pray even after this session got over. The containment of the virus. There are several containment area. There some of the areas are labeled as green spot, yellow spot and a red spot. And we are well aware of this, it's these things. So the people are struggling, the government is struggling, and the rulers of all the nations, they are vehemently struggling. The downfall of the economy is in another hand, and the ordinary people's livelihood is not seen, and the human beings are vehemently devastated, and this is the scenario. We have to pray for the containment of the virus. We have to focus on the virus. Lord, let the virus be killed by the blood of the Lamb. If we can pray like that, definitely God's intervention in all the nations and the people who are severely affected, they will be healed and they will come out of the struggle. The first point is that God should intervene in nations that you know that has been severely affected. You know many of the countries. You have to bring such countries in your prayer. Shall we look to the Lord in prayer? Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you, Master, for the grace you have granted unto us to intercede for the people who are in need. Father, we pray for the containment areas. We beg unto thee, O Lord, we ask of your intervention in all the containment areas. And as they are being treated, Father, let the healing come upon such people and let the treatment be effective, because we know that Christ, the blood of Jesus only heals the people, O Master. Let the blood of Christ sprinkle over the containment area and all the people in those containment area. Bless them, Lord, deliver them in Jesus' name. Amen. And the second point for the spread to stop. The people, that is the, as we know, this has come from some country, and we are not aware of the virus, from where it comes. Now it is spreading around. Now the community spread is going to take place, according to my understanding, in the light of the message we received through the media. The community spread has been already taken place. So this is the very pathetic scene. So pray for the spread to stop, the community spread to stop. Father, we pray that the community spread be stopped in your name and the people be delivered, O Master. Father God, they don't know, they don't have the privilege of doing their assigned duties and responsibilities for their livelihood. It is being affected vehemently, O Father. You send your word and let the community spread be stopped in Jesus' name. Thank you, Master, for answering our prayers. Third point we have taken, the God to give doctors the right solution. Doctors are now in utter confusion, because the medical practitioners, they went ahead and they treated the patients with a closer watch, and now they are caught up in a sense. Some of the doctors, they have lost their lives. The insecure feeling, the kind of feeling is captured. The doctors are captured now, and we have to pray for the doctors. And Father God, we thank you, Master, for the privilege you have granted unto the doctors to heal the sick. You have anointed the doctors for a special task to heal the sick. Father God, as they get involved in the rescue operation or in the forefront, let them be protected, O Master. And what all the treatment they give, Father God, let the people be healed in Jesus' name. Thank you, Master, for this time of prayer. Continuously, let's pray together. For the death toll to stop throughout all the nations, it is more than 2,52,950 as on yesterday. And now we have to ask God to stop the death toll. If we lose one of the members of the family, our distant family, how do we struggle, and our hearts are how much bereavement we feel in our heart. So we have to take it as a challenge and ask God, plead God to stop the death toll. Lord Jesus, we pour out our heart unto thee, O Lord. You are the God of compassion, O Master. You are the omniscient, omnipotent Lord. Nothing is impossible unto thee. Let thy power come upon all the nations and the death toll be stopped, O Master. Let the people live, Father God. Be gracious unto them. Forgive all their sins. And let's continuously pray for the speedy recovery of all infected patients worldwide. Infected patients are given several other areas, quarantine and some of the other areas. So the people who are there infected, we have to pray for them. Father God, we come unto thy presence for the people who are infected with the coronavirus. Father, we pray for the speedy recovery. Let them be recovered from the clutches of devil, O Master, from the bondages of the cruel coronavirus. Let the blood of Christ sprinkle over the people who are infected by this coronavirus. And let the stripes of Christ Jesus heal them, Lord. Let them be healed, the speedy recovery be seen in their infected patients, O Master, in Jesus' name. Amen. Another point, the divine protection of the uninfected. There are some uninfected people who are in utter confusion, who are in insecure feeling. I don't know what is going to mean in the days to come. Like that tendency people are having, an insecure feeling. And due to that, many people are put under stress and frustration. And this leads the people into another turmoil. So we pray, we ask God to protect the uninfected people. Loving Father, we come unto thy presence for the deliverance of the uninfected people. There are some uninfected people. Father, we know that around Baikula and Father God, some other areas in Mahim and some other areas in Worli and Borivali and Mira Road and some other areas, and in India as a whole and several other countries, we pray for the uninfected people's security. Let the uninfected people be protected, O Master, by the power of the Holy Spirit. Father, we surrender all the uninfected people. Let them be completely secure in your name. Because the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run to it and be saved. Let them be safe in Jesus' name. Amen. And let's continue to pray for the people who work in the front line. Healthcare workers, hospital workers, doctors, nurses, medical researchers, technicians, sanitization workers, municipal corporation workers, those who have good hearts working in the front line should be protected. Let's remember such people. Father, we thank you, Master, for thy protective hand. Let the nail-pierced hand protect the people who are in the front line to attack the coronavirus. Father God, let the people be completely, the people who are in the rescue operation be completely protected, O Lord. And let the volunteers, the people, the protective forces, the police officers, many IAS officers, they were also affected with this virus. Father, we fall prostrate before thee, O Lord. Have mercy upon thy people, O Master. Let thy people be delivered. Let the doctors and the medical practitioner and who are in the forefront be completely covered by the precious blood of the Lamb. Let them be protected, O Master. As they treat the people, let the people be healed in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Master, for answering our prayers. Similarly, for our Indian, for our economy, the response to current circumstances has put a great strain in our Indian economy as well as the world economy, including small business. We can have the faith to pray for our economy in the following ways. Pray for the fear would cease, the economy activities would pick up again. Pray for the financial health and small business. Pray for the supernatural renewal of resources. Pray for the protection of jobs for fellow believers. Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you, Master, for this time of divine protection, for the time of prayer, for the time of intercession. As a church, we acknowledge thy presence in our midst, O Father. We know that you are seated on the throne, highly exalted. When we ask, it will be granted. Father, in one accord, as a church, as a redeemed community, we come unto thy presence, O Father, to stabilize the economy of India, the economy of all the nations, United Nations, Spain, Portugal, England, Burma, Russia, hallelujah, neighboring countries, Gulf countries, hallelujah, Father God, European countries. Let the nation, let the economy be firm, O Father. Let the economy be revived, retrieved, O Father, by the power of the Christ Jesus, and renew all the resources. And there are many jobless people. Father God, let them find the job, O Master, in the days to come. And let the situation be normal. In your name, let the situation be brought unto normal, O Father, by the shedding of the blood on the cross. Father God, you have shed thy blood throughout the streets of Jerusalem. You have shed your sweat in the garden of Gethsemane. Father God, we pray, O Lord, let the sweat and the blood of Christ heal the people from all the infirmities, especially the COVID-19 pandemic disease. Remember, in Jesus' name, remember, we are all under the world economy, and Jesus never fails, and God is able to stabilize the world economy, and people will have welfare, people will have the rehabilitation. With that hope, let's commit all the people of all the nations. Father, we pray that you would stretch out the hands and touch them, Lord. Touch all the nations. Let the nations be protected from all evils and all dangers, O Master. We do pray for them. Father God, pregnant women all over the world, as they are ready to give birth to their children. Father God, let them not be infected. Let them be protected, O Master. Let them be given right treatment. Father God, let them be taken care of, Father. Let the child birth be proper, O Master. Let them be given good care, O Father. We thank you, Master, for the facilities. They are the government of India and other governments are planning to render this pregnant woman. Let the pregnant woman be protected by the giving, by childbirth, O Master. Be with all the ladies, be with all the nations. We pray for the wisdom to the leaders of the nations. Father, we know that you are the God who has appointed the leaders of all the nations. As this situation is going beyond their control, grant them wisdom to Father God to keep it in control, because you are in control. We know that nothing is impossible unto thee. Let the system and the functions of the whole society in all the uttermost parts of this earth be in control in Jesus' name. Thank you, Master, for the blood you have shed on the cross. We have the refuge, the blood of Jesus. Let the blood of Jesus be pronounced and bring, Father God, healing unto the nation, O Father. Thank you, Master, for the divine mercy you have extended unto us. Father, we pray for the church, the local church, the church at large. Many people are praying. Many people are on their knees. Father God, remember them, Lord. And the people who are godly, people who are seeking thy divine providence every now and then in their lives, in the given time. Father God, let them be blessed, O Lord. Let them be protected, O Master. Father God, we do remember the Borivali Methodist English Church and the people of the church, O Master, who are worshipping community. Touch their lives, O Master. Let the anointing of the Holy Spirit come upon all the people, of the church, O Master. Let the church be revived and edified. Let the church be protected from every possible harm and the fouler snares and this kind of pandemic diseases, epidemic. Father, we pray for the elderly members of the church, Mrs. and Mr. B.B. Daniel, Mrs. and Mr. P.E. John, Mrs. and Mr. Father God, Dr. Sohalkar and Surekha Sohalkar, Mrs. Rajkumari Ajitram, and Dr. P.C. David, and Mrs. and Mr. Obale, Mrs. and Mr. Hari Salins, Mrs. and Mr. Manfred, and Father God, several other dear ones who have attained the age in well advanced years, you remember them, Lord, and you protect them from all kinds of possible dangers. We pray for the Mrs. and Mr. Chopra, and Father God, we thank you, Master, for the way you have protected this beloved one thus far, who are people who are redeemed by the precious blood of the Lamb. Continuously, Father God, make a provision for them, O Lord. Let thy grace be felt among them, O Father, and fill them, Lord, with your Spirit. And pray for the Rhoda, Dora, Jeremiah, and Mrs. Dora Jeremiah, and Mr. Manish Talgote, and Mrs. Talgote, and Mr. Davare. Father, we know that most of the members of our church are in need of thy touch, O Master. Let the divine touch be felt among them, O Father. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. This is the word of the Lord. You have granted unto us, Lord. Let the people be protected from all kinds of possible dangers, O Master. Let the insecure feeling be wiped out from the minds and hearts of the people of your choice. People who are godly, O Master. Especially let the godly people, Father, rejoice and be glad in you, O Lord, and protect the people of all the nations, especially our church, Father God. We thank you, Master, for answering our prayers. Now we do remember Mr. Manish Talgote, as he's bedridden for several years. Father God, be gracious unto him and protect him, Lord, from all kinds of viruses attack. Father, we pray for all the people of our church, O Master. We do remember the people who are settled in abroad from our church. Father, we pray, O Lord, let thy hand, protective hand, be upon them. Many of our church members and their relatives, their kith and kin, they are settled in abroad in different countries, O Master. Let the protection be granted unto them. As a church, we pray in one accord. Let the people be protected. Let the people's provision be given, O Lord. Let the people's grocery, the vegetables, vegetation, and several other needs be met, O Father. Let the people exchange their well-being, each other, from our country to the country where they are. Be with them, Lord, in a special way. Thank you, Master, for answering our prayers. Let's pray for the online worship service which is going on. And now we have come unto God's presence in this first Wednesday after a long time. Let it be continued on, Father God, if it is thy will, let it be continued on every Wednesday, so Master. Be with all the people of God, and especially the godly people, be completely protected, O Master. We do remember Mrs. Lakshmi Rogers for their well-being. We pray for Mr. and Mrs. R.J. Paul, and we pray for Mr. Johnny Cohen and Mrs. Johnny Cohen, and we commit Mr. Henry, Ronald Henry and Mrs. Ronald Henry, and we pray for Mr. Mohan Massey and Mrs. Malati Massey, and Mr. J.G. Daniel and Mrs. J.G. Daniel. And all the members of the church, we commit them unto their loving care, O Master. Let them be completely protected from all kinds of possible dangers. Father God, let the blood of Christ be seen on their doorpost, on their houses, O Master. And let them be guarded by the Spirit of the living God. Thank you, Master, for this time of prayer, time of worship. The things which you have not asked, you are supposed to ask, be granted unto us for thy glory and for the edification of the church. Thank you, Master, for this time of together. Father God, we do remember my family. Father God, as a family together, you have enabled us to come unto thy presence as a family together. Bless our family in a special way, O Master. Thank you, Master, for this time of prayer. We give you all glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' most matchless name, who taught us to pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory forever and ever. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father Almighty, and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, both now and forevermore.
God bless you. Stay safe.